Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to start a new exciting series on using Microsoft Sway. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. If you've never heard of Microsoft Sway before, you might be saying, "What is Microsoft Sway?" Well, Microsoft Sway is a way to create really good-looking documents that you can view online in the form of a presentation or even like a simple website. So let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. Here is one of the featured sways inside of Microsoft Sway. And if you look down here, you can see some arrows pointing left and right. So this is kind of like an online slideshow. And this one happens to be on Mount Rainier. So if I start clicking to the right, I can see different slides and some text that goes along with those slides. So if I keep clicking and advancing, or if I use the scroll bar on my mouse and just go down, I can go through all the pictures about Mount Rainier and all the text that was entered here. And you can see that I'm scrolling to the right. I can also scroll up and down. And there's a lot of other settings that we can use to change what this looks like. But for now, I just wanted you to get the idea of what a sway is. So think about using this for displaying a vacation, or perhaps you want to have a good presentation for the annual report of your company, or even using this as a timeline slideshow, like say someone's getting married or it's an anniversary and you have a whole history of pictures of that person maybe growing up. So anytime you have a presentation that you would like to use, Microsoft Sway is a good tool for that. So how do you get started using Microsoft Sway? Basically, just go up here to office.com. And you will be taken to the online version of Office. Now, usually Sway does not appear over here on the left, but there are two ways to get to Microsoft Sway. One, you can click the apps here and scroll down until you see the Sway app, or go up here to this waffle, which is called the App Launcher, and go to All Apps and scroll down, and you can see Sway among the S's right here. So just click on that button, and we come to the Sway home screen. So you have a couple options here. You can create a new Sway, which is what we're going to do in a few minutes. You can start from a topic. There's various topics that you can search for. Or you can start from a document. So if you already have a Word document or a PowerPoint or a PDF somewhere, you can upload that document and start using it in Sway. So just a few more things to show you down here. You can see your Sways that you've created in the past. You can see sways that you've viewed from other places. And you can also get some analytics on any of the sways that you have in these previous two screens. And you can also go back here to deleted sways. Then if I scroll down here, I can start a sway from a template. And you can see that I have several different options. I can create a newsletter. I can create a resume, some business presentations, a photo collection, etc. And then down here is a featured sway. That's where I got the one on Mount Rainier. Okay, so let's get started creating a new sway. If I go here to create new, I will be taken to the sway right here. So what I decided to do today, because I actually need to do this later on this week, is creating a recipe for how to bake a chocolate and raspberry torte. I'm going to double click in here and just type how to make a chocolate raspberry torte. So let's go over what some of these things are up here. I am creating a storyline. So you can kind of think of anything as a storyline, a series of pictures, the way you want your presentation to flow, steps in making a recipe, which is what we are going to do today, what you did on day one of your vacation versus day two of your vacation, what your annual report looked like on quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, etc. So that is what's known as a storyline. You can also go to design over here, but we don't have anything yet to design until we create a few more parts of our sway. This right here is called a card. And there's a couple different things I can do to my card. I can emphasize, which is basically like bolding. I can accent, which is like italicizing. If I know where the recipe is online, I can actually put it right here. I can also add a background picture. So I'm going to click on that for now. And I'm going to search chocolate And look, a chocolate raspberry tour appears right here. So I'm just going to click on that picture and see what some of my options are. And this one looks really good, so I'm just going to click and drag it over here. You can also click and drag a picture from your computer in the same way. Or you could also come up here to suggested, and you could find files on your OneDrive. You can use a video on YouTube or images from any of these other places, including your device. I can also search videos, and I can also insert some of these videos if I would like. So one other thing with using an image is if I go to focus points, I can scroll down here and I can see what this image is going to look like across the top of my web page. And I can also look over here and see what it's going to look like on a mobile phone. So I can select this option that the entire image is important, and you can see right here that it will automatically resize, or I can uncheck that and I can click on the picture itself. Say I think this little raspberry in the middle is the most important part of the picture. I can click on that and you can see that my picture down here is moving. Or what if I want the top? I can click over here and the picture down here has moved. It allows you to recenter the image once it's zoomed in. So that's what the focus points are. So I'm going to X out of there, and then I'm going to start creating the flow of my presentation. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So this will be the first part of my presentation. And if I want to go down here to insert content, I have a couple different options here. I can insert another image, or I can insert a heading or some text. I can also upload a file or go to the media option over here, and I can put in some images, video, audio, etc. So I'm going to go back to suggested, and I'm just going to insert some text. And I'm going to say, I am going to make a delicious tort tonight. And then if I click on this plus sign right here again, I'm going to click on image, and let's search for an image of the first step of my recipe. So step one of a recipe usually is to gather all your ingredients. And I chose a really simple tort recipe because I don't want to spend my whole night cooking. So I'm going to list out all the ingredients right here. But first I'm going to say gather ingredients. So my ingredients here are chocolate, butter, eggs, water, cocoa, and confectionery sugar. So over here, I'm going to find another image and I'm going to search on chocolate. So let's get some chocolate. And I'm just going to leave it at chocolate because that's the main ingredient. So next, let's go down here and add another image. And the first thing we're going to do is melt the butter and chocolate together. Over here, I'm going to just type chocolate melt. And I'm going to pick this picture of melted chocolate and just stick it over here. Then I'll add my next step with an image and just say beat the egg yolks. Next, I typed beat egg yolks in a KitchenAid because that's what I'm doing. So I'm just going to take this picture and drag that over here. And then I'm going to go to the next step and insert an image and say, once yolks are frothy, add cocoa powder and mix more. So over here, I'm just going to pick cocoa powder and I'm just going to drag that picture over here. Now, this is a nice thing about going back and editing really quickly. I realized I forgot to tell you to let this mixture cool, and I forgot to add the sugar. So right here, I'm going to type 1/3 of the sugar and then cool. And then over here, I'm going to say beat the egg yolks with the rest of the sugar. So I'm also going to scroll up and make sure we've already used all my ingredients. We used the chocolate, the butter, the eggs, and the cocoa powder. And I also made a mistake up here. This shouldn't say water. It should just say sugar. And then I'm going to add my next step down here, and I'm going to put one more image, and I'm going to say fold the chocolate into the egg mixture slowly and mix well by hand. So I'm going to look up fold chocolate into egg yolks and get this picture and drag that over here. And then my next step is also going to be an image that says pour mix into greased pan. And over here, I'm going to type in pour cake mix and use this image. I'm going to add one more image. And then on this step, I'm going to say bake at 325 for 35 to 40 minutes. And then over here, I'm just going to get a picture of an oven and I'll just drag this one over. And then my very last step is going to be when cake cools, dust with powdered sugar and add raspberries to the top. And I'm going to just drag this picture over here after I search for confectionery sugar cake. And I'm also going to remember that I forgot to put raspberries in my ingredient list. Just say one pack. And then I'm going to hit the X over here and let's check out our sway. I can do that by going over here to design and scrolling to the top. Here's my title across the top of how to make a chocolate raspberry torte. Here's my comment on making the delicious torte tonight. Here's all my ingredients with the picture of the chocolate. Here's me melting the butter, beating the eggs, adding the cocoa powder, folding the chocolate into the eggs, pouring it into the pan, baking it, and then putting confectionery sugar on top. So what else can we do to this design here? If we go over to styles, this is where the sway can come in vertically or horizontally. So by default, I was scrolling downward and you could see that that was a vertical sway. But when I showed you the Mount Rainier one, it was going across instead of down. So that was a horizontal sway. I can also show it as a slideshow, and this would be good if you're doing a presentation. I can also come down here and see the different types of styles that I could apply. And you can see that my fonts are changing every time I click a different one of these. I can also change my font so the background is a solid color like this or like this. I can use one of these fun styles down here. And I think I'm going to go with that one because that looks a little more like a recipe to me. But you have a lot of options up here. If you hit this remix button, it will automatically take you through different types of fonts that you can have, and maybe you'll find one that you like this way. But I'm going to go with this one right here. And I'm also going to go back to the vertical one because I showed you a horizontal one in the beginning of this video. Okay, so say I am ready now to go with my sway. So if I go up here and I hit the play button, I can see what my sway is going to look like. And if I scroll down, I can see that my images are coming up on the screen as I go through each one of the steps in my presentation. I can share this sway with others by clicking on the share button, and I can invite people to view my sway, but I can also invite them to edit my sway. So say we're working on a team project, other people can change the sway with the edits that they may have. So I can copy this link and email it to someone. I can get a visual link. So if I click on that button, you can see right here that this could be copied and inserted into an email. It's just a little more pleasing to the eye than just a direct text link. If I close that and go back to share, I can also share this on Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn. I can also embed my code right here to a website so that there's a direct link on the website to this sway. If I close that and go back to share, I also have more options down here where I can require a password to view or edit the sway. So you might want to do that depending on how sensitive your information is in your sway. I can also go up here to these settings and I can do an autoplay, which will go through the different parts of my sway every 3 seconds, and I can adjust that to 60 seconds. So let's do 3 seconds and let's see what that looks like. So you can see that my slides automatically advance when I have the autoplay on. So if I click here, I can adjust those settings as well. So if I scroll back to the top and go to edit and click these three buttons, I can create a new sway without having to go back to the sway main menu. I can also duplicate this sway. Say there's something in here and I just want to edit a few things and create a whole new sway. Instead of starting from scratch, I can just make a duplicate of this one. I can actually save it as a template to be used in the future. And I can print and I can also export. So let's go right here to export. And you can export this to Word or a PDF. So I'm going to close that and go back here to the Sway main menu. And now you can see that my Sway is available right here. And if I click these three buttons, I can play this Sway. I can get a link to this Sway. I can make a copy of this Sway, or I can delete this Sway. So hopefully that gives you a decent introduction to Microsoft Sway, what it does, and how to create one really quickly. I highly recommend that you do not cook this recipe that I put out here the way that it is, because I really just threw together a bunch of instructions and you probably won't end up with a really delicious chocolate raspberry tort. So I recommend going out to the internet and finding a better recipe than what I put there and making one this weekend. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.